This is the first video from the series dedicated to teaching you how to build your own design systems in Figma. I'm assuming you are familiar with Figma components and auto layout, as they are essential for making the design systems. If not, I have covered auto layout and how to make components in my previous videos. You will find them in the video description. Now, when people talk about design systems in the context of Figma, 99% of the time they are referring to libraries of styles and components. Design system in a true sense is not only the library of reusable components, but also documentation of how to use specific elements and in what situations. It's also an extension of a product or organization brand. In Figma, you can take any file and publish it as a library. From this point forward, you can utilize its contents in other files and projects across your entire Figma account. You can do so by selecting the Team Library icon in the Assets panel. Now at the top of the menu, you will see your current file name and the publish button. Once selected, you will have ability to pick what styles and components will be published. After that, you hit publish and you are good to go. From that moment, within any file across your Figma account, you will have the ability to activate and use it as a library under the Team Library icon. Components of activated libraries will be accessible in the Assets panel. As for the styles, they will be applicable through styles icon in the design panel. Libraries are bound to the Figma account, so if you wish to move them to another one, you need to export them. You can do so through the Figma main menu by selecting File and then Save Local Copy. Now you can import that file to any other Figma account by simply dragging and dropping it to any project. When working on design systems, it's best to follow something called Atomic Design Methodology. Atomic Design is a methodology composed of 5 distinct stages, working together to create design systems in deliberate and hierarchical manner. Those 5 stages are atoms, molecules, organisms, templates, and finally pages. The atoms serve as the building blocks for all of our user interfaces. These atoms include basic elements like labels, inputs, buttons, and other ones that can't be broken down any further. Then we have molecules that are simple groups of atoms joined together. For example, a form label, search input, and a button can be joined together to create a search form molecule. Organisms are components composed of groups of molecules and/or atoms and/or other organisms. These organisms form distinct sections of an interface. Let's consider the mentioned search form molecule. A search form is often found in the header section of many interfaces. So let's combine it with other molecules to create a header organism. Templates are page-level objects that consist of various organisms and build our layouts. Let's build upon the previous example and add other organisms to our header to create the homepage template of a website. Pages are the last element of Atomic methodology, where templates are generic representations of layouts populated with dummy content. Pages are using templates as a baseline and replacing dummy content with realistic one. In contrast to what I found about building design systems in other videos or tutorials, and even in the atomic methodology I just described, I personally believe that it's better to design a couple of pages first and then disassemble them into smaller pieces once you get a good grasp of style, colors, and other key aspects of your project. I can hear you thinking now, wait, what? Then why did you make this lengthy introduction about this other stuff first, and now you're saying to do the exact opposite? Let me use a car industry analogy for this to better explain that. When a company is developing a new car, first it starts by producing a couple of prototypes to figure out how the car could look and work like. This would be our design and test phase. Then, once the company is happy, it ironed out the details and tested the prototype. It's time for preparing the assembly line and streamlining the production. This would be our atomic approach and design system phase. It's easier and faster because you know what you're building and how the end product should look like. It will also provide you with the guidelines for the list of parts you will need. That's why it's better to design something first, test it, disassemble it, and only then start building a design system instead of building it from the atoms up. Otherwise, you will be trying to create atoms and other elements, not even knowing what you are designing for. I just don't get why everyone is explaining this the other way around. Anyway, what I want you to do right now is to design something or to use one of your existing projects as your baseline that you will use for your design system. Once you have it, you will then disassemble it to atoms and you will use atomic methodology to build your design system, which we will start doing in the next video that will be available here. For now though, you may see something else here, so stay tuned.